All right, guys, it's midsummer and it's time to check in and see how our perennial plots are doing and handling the heat and dry weather. Perennial plots on a recreational farm can be dynamite attractions and oftentimes require minimal maintenance because you're not planting them so much, but not every perennial plot is created equal. And it's important for us to look and learn at the different windows or time frames that both of them can shine and the differences, right? So here we're in a perennial clover stand. Now we got a couple different types of clover and chicory in this plot, but predominantly we have white clover and we have red clover, chicory, and just a few sprigs of alfalfa mixed in here. But most importantly, we can all see that, man, the heat and dry of mid-July is really taking its toll on the white clover. This is a common scene for whitetail managers across the country during midsummer, right? The white clover doesn't take the heat very well. Generally, white clover has no more than a 2-foot root system, so it can't get but so far below the ground in its root system to grab water and hold water, right? So if you're dry up top, the clover is just not going to do that well. And then the heat doesn't help things either. In comparison, red clover tends to do better later into the summer months. This is red clover. It's got a broader leaf. Deer have been foraging on this sprout specifically, a little bit more right over here and out in front of me some more. But white clover is already flowered, but really a lot of it has just been set back too from the heat. But by having the different forages in here, that's great to extend a little bit more beyond the life of just white clover. But in all regards, this is very expected, very typical of clover stands. As we get closer to season, later in the summer, we're gonna have longer nights, we're gonna have more dew in the morning, and that's gonna revive some of the clover and allow it to pop and prepare itself back for season. So I'm not worried about this, and really not worried about the annual weeds in here too. We'll mow before season, probably spray a pursuit application going into the fall, but really they're not bothering me one bit. And even here's mayor's tail, and deer have been browsing on mayor's tail right here in the clover plot. So very typical stand, but does it compare to alfalfa? Let's take a look. All right, guys, we've shifted over just a little bit in this plot to the alfalfa stand. This is a year one alfalfa stand, and as you can tell, it's been harvested once already this year, but it's not showing signs of incredible stress like the white clover has. This is much more heat tolerant and drought tolerant as well. That's because of the root structure of the plant. This can have root structures, alfalfa can have root structures 15 foot deep compared to 2 foot deep of white clover. So no matter what, alfalfa is going to do amazing or much better in an environment that has minimal rain, that experiences a lot of heat. And so going into season, I'm fully expecting, and last night there was a bachelor group of bucks in the plot, but more deer being attracted to this forage because of the drought tolerance and heat tolerance that it has. So as native vegetation gets a little bit less desirable later into the summer, and as clover is not as desirable, an alfalfa stand is still gonna hold its own and tolerate the heat, tolerate the browse pressure and potential dryness and get you into season with probably a lot of deer in the field. But when you're talking pound for pound, acre for acre, during the heat of the summer, alfalfa is going to do a lot better. But white clover is going to do probably a little bit better on the ends of the hot summer, right? Probably going to do a little bit better in the early spring and probably do a little bit better later in the winter than alfalfa. It's best to have both perennial crops on a property. They span a little different windows there, but no matter what, if I'm going to rely on a forage for extreme heat and drought, it's definitely going to be alfalfa opposed to white clover from a perennial food source.